and he who has found his life will lose it, and he who has lost his life for my sake will find it.
Excuse me. I've shared this with you before. This was a letter written 28th of May, 2004. And this was a letter from tribal people in the Doe tribe in the Finisterre Mountains. And this was given to a friend of mine who was working with the Mibu tribe, several mountain ranges away. Not very many miles away, but 1,000 feet up, then 1,000 feet down, cross a raging river, another 3,000 feet up, 4,000 feet down, and another mile over the ridge. It may as well be another world. And they walked over into Mibu, and they gave this letter to Joey. I should have Craig read for you the talk pigeon version of it, but the translation is, "I'm happy to come talk to you guys. We talked about you sending a missionary to come to us, but you have not done it. And so we are still waiting. So this letter in 2004 from the Doe people was a second attempt to get a missionary to bring God's message to their language. Open invitation. Welcome, Matt. Please, come share the gospel. Give us the scriptures. Written in 2004. And the 2004 letter said, "We're still waiting." I didn't see this until 2008. And we held this up in front of our church body. And read it, like I'm reading it to you now. And we said, does anybody want to do this? That will not end. Oh, children, come. Lay down all your bitterness. Turn from sin's toil. We see it again in Isaiah 48:11. Look at Isaiah 48:11. Again, we see God actively being committed to this end. Isaiah 48 in verse number 11, for my own sake I will act. It's a question, for how can my name be profaned? And my glory I will not give to another. God is not a sharer of his glory. And if he was such, he would be withholding honor from that which is most worthy of honor. That the reason that God cannot do anything ultimately to exalt another name is because his name and his name alone is most worthy of praise. His name, it's his character, it's who he really is.